This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. To order, upload Gerber files from your computer. After checking the details and price on the next page, save to cart and then check out securely. Also, every customer will get $7 and $8 free engineering fee for SMT assembly orders.
Hi guys, these two what you see are permanent magnet DC motors. Now in my previous video, you must have seen a motor similar to this one. This is a car power window motor. It is a little bigger. So in this video, I'm going to show what's inside this motor, like how big the armature and the magnets are. And after completing that, I'm going to proceed to this part in which I'm going to salvage the motor out of this geared windshield wiper motor set. Okay, so guys, the screws are out now. It's finally time to open the armature casing. Okay. First, I'm going to show you the field winding. So guys, the field magnets are somewhat similar to the previous one, except a little bigger and with a little more space in between. Now comes the armature. The armature winding is much thicker for this one than the one I showed you in the previous video. So obviously this is going to produce much more amperes as current. It is running really smooth. So guys, just to show you the performance, I'm going to give it a quick run with a 12 volts battery. Okay. Now let's proceed with the car windshield motor. Here you see the label, it's barely visible. So these are the three screws provided for the installed gearbox. Let's open these up. So guys, this is the gearbox. These are the two wires with which it is going to run. And that's the geared shaft that is used to run this plastic piece. So guys, I forgot the part in which I wanted to show you this motor in the running state with a 12 volts battery. Yeah, now this is not going to come out. You see, pretty giant clips. Okay, so guys, keep watching this shaft. You see, it is running pretty good. And this clip is holding it perfectly, the gearbox. So guys, now that you have seen it's working in the geared mode, let's remove the gearbox. So that's the shaft, that's the plastic gear inside the box. Let's remove it from here. Now all that remains is this motor. Let's open up these two screws. Okay, so guys, let's open it up. Let's see what's inside. So yeah, you can see this uses the special kind of three brushes for operation. Never seen such kind of commutator before. That's because I haven't opened a motor like this before. Well, I'm more interested in the armature winding. Yeah, you can see a really thick winding has been used and two big permanent magnets are there. Let's hold it because it is all greased up. Holding it with a cloth. Wow, now that's a very cool looking armature. You can see it's as good as new. The commutator is also very healthy. There is no rupturing of the copper bars, and you can see how thick the copper winding is. Very nice. Cool, right? I'll zoom it for you. Still looks like new copper. Now comes the bearing. You can see the good thing about this motor is that the use of bearing on the lower base, as you can see, and large magnets have been used. concave ones. The quality inside is pretty good. It might be bad looking or awful looking from outside, but it still looks like new from inside. So guys, here as you can see, the health of the brushes indicate that the motor hasn't been used much. So yeah, it's time to cut off this part of the gear and then see how it works out. Now cutting it, because it's a metal piece, is going to be a little bit tricky, and also I'm going to place it on a strong vise. So guys, as you can see that after hammering this piece and cutting it little by little, I finally got the head of the motor out of the gearbox, the metal piece. Now let's improve the edges and connect it to the motor, thereby testing it after that. So guys, as you can see that the head of this motor is completely ready to be used in a proper way. Okay, so guys, these are the parts that will be used for completing this into a motor. So this is completely finished now. So let's place everything back. First, the armature winding in the field. It's gone. You can see it is rotating freely. Yeah, magnetic locking is pretty good. Comes the second part. The spring, you see. Now the commutator brush part. Now the first one. Yeah, first one is inside. Let's keep it held like this. Yeah, same for the other two. So yeah, as you can see, all the brushes are held back properly. Now let's place the shaft. Just going to get in here. There is going to be a little bit problem, I think. I should place the armature in first, otherwise it is not going to sink. Now I have to keep it held over here with the help of some holder or something. So for that I'm going to use this clip again. It's held strongly. So guys, I have already removed the stoppers for the brushes inside before I placed it in back. So let's remove this clip.
Okay.
It's almost ready. I have to tighten up the screws. That's all. Okay, that's one. So guys, the motor is finally complete. You see? So guys, finally it's time to test the motor. See, it's a high current motor. Pretty good, right? So yeah guys, once more with a closer view. Oh, really high torque. I have to hold it steady. So guys, this was the test in the motoring mode. Now comes the test in the generating mode. So pointing the meter towards 20 volts DC mode. Let's see how much voltage it can generate. Meter pointing at zero and the terminals have been connected. Yeah, it's a little difficult to run it this way. I'm going to use a drill chuck for it. Okay, keep watching the display screen. Almost 1 volt. 1.19. Yeah, so 1 volt is the maximum that I am able to generate here. Now the current in 10 amperes and measured in hand rotation. Yeah, 0.3 amps is the maximum that I'm getting over here. Now guys, I'm going to use this rope for current measurement first, and after that the voltage measurement. Yeah, the rope has been bound. Okay, keep watching the display screen. Yeah, 2.43 amps, although the rope broke. Once again guys, 2.63. Now the voltage is 20 volts. Okay, so 6.37 volts was the maximum I could get. Okay, keep watching the screen. Okay, now the voltage was somewhere around 11 volts. Let's measure the current same way. Current measurement, direct shaft rope rotation. So yeah, you guys saw it generated somewhere around 5 amperes.